Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Learn Commerce Easily. I'm Namita Mane. In today's session, we will study Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation. How to solve Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation sum. Basically, Carl Pearson is denoted by small r. Formula to calculate Carl Pearson: R is equals to sum of xy minus n, n is number of observation, x bar, y bar, divided by bracket sum of x square minus n, x bar square, bracket close, multiply sum of y square minus n, y bar square, bracket close, and whole under the square root. Now, there are six steps to calculate Carl Pearson. First step is obtain sum of x, means total of x. Step 2, obtain sum of y. Step 3, find sum of squares of x. Step 4, obtain sum of square of y. Step 5, obtain sum of product of x and y. And finally, find Carl Pearson by applying the formula. Here is the formula. Now let us see one example. Calculate Carl Pearson correlation from the following data between price and demand. This is the data, price and demand solution. Now first we will denote price and demand with x and y. Price as x, demand as y. So, x is the value of prices. So, write down all the value of price. 10, 11, 14, 14, 20, 22, 16, 12, 15, 13. Demand is denoted as y. So, all the value of y. 12, 14, 15, 16, 21, 26, 21, 15, 16, 14. Now next we have to find x square, means this is x, so x square. 10 square is what? 100. 11 square is 121. 14 square is 196. 14 number is repeated again, 196. 20 square is 400. 22, 484. 16, 256. 12, 144. 15, 225. 13, 169. Now next we have to find y square. So y square, 12 square is 144, 14 196, 15 225, 16 256, 21 441, 26 676, 21 441, 15 225, 16 256, 14 196. Now next, x and y means product of x and y, means x multiply by y. So 10 multiply by 12 we get 120, 11 multiply by 14 154, 14 multiply 15, 1, sorry, 2, 1, 0, 2, 10. 14 multiply 16, double 2, 4. 20 multiply 21, 4, 20. 22 multiply 26, 5, 7, 2. 16 multiply 21, double 3, 6. 12 multiply 15, 1, 80. 15 multiply 16, 240. 13 multiply 14, 182. Now we have to find the total of x, y, x square, y square, and x and y. So total of the x column is 147, y column is 170, x square is 2219, y square is 3056, last xy 2638. Now we got all the total. This will be called as sum of x, sum of y, sum of x square, sum of y square, and sum of x and y. So next, apply the formula. Step 6 is apply the formula. Write down the formula. R is equals to sum of xy minus n x bar, n x bar y bar, then bracket sum of x square minus n x bar square, bracket close, multiply sum of y square minus n y bar square, and this is whole under the square root. Now as per the formula, we have got the value of sum of x and y. This is sum of x and y. N is what? The number of observation, means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So N is what? 10. X bar and y bar we have to find. Sum of x square, here is the value of sum of x square. Y square, here is the value of y square. So basically now we have to find x bar and y bar. So to find x bar, sum of x divided by n. So sum of x is what? 147. 147 divided by 10. So n is what? 10. So 147 divided by 10, we get 14.7. Y bar, sum of y divided by n. So sum of y is 170 divided by 10. So we get 17. Okay. So we will put all the values as per the formula. First is sum of xy. Sum of xy is 2638 minus n is 10. X bar we got as 10. X bar we got as 14.7 multiply 14.7 multiply y bar we got 17. Then bracket sum of x square is what? 2291 minus n is 10 multiply x bar square, means 14.7 square, multiply sum of y square is 3056 minus 10 multiply 17 square and whole under the square root. Next is equals to 2638 minus 10 multiply 14.7 multiply 17, we get 2499. Bracket double 291 as it is. 14.7 square multiply by 10, we get 2160.9. Bracket close, multiply 3056 right as it is, minus 17 square into 10, we get 2890. Bracket close, and this is whole under the square root. 2638 minus 2499, we get 139. Then minus 2219 minus 2160.9, we get 130.1. Multiply 3056 minus 2890, we get 166, and this is under the square root. First multiply this to 130.1 into 166, we will get answer. Write the answer under the square root, 21596.6. Now find the square root of 21596.6. We get 139 upon 146.95. Now divide this, is equals to 0.9458. So we got the answer as 0.9458. So the correlation between price and demand is 0.9458. Thank you. Please subscribe my YouTube channel.